fellow viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I am your tutor, Sarah Omega. So today I'm going to take you through CRE Form 1, Lesson 9. We are still under the topic Creation and the Fall of Humankind. So today we are going to look at the biblical stories of creation. Welcome. We start with our lesson objectives. What is the learner expected? By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to state the similarities between the two accounts of creation. Two, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to describe the difference between the two accounts of creation. We have looked at the creation stories. We have looked at the first account of creation in Genesis 1, and we have looked at the second account of creation in Genesis 2. So we want to see the difference between the two accounts of creation. In the first account of creation, there's mention what was created on which day. Each creation takes each day. So in the first account of creation, each creation takes a day. While in the second account of creation, it doesn't mention the daily activities of God, and there's no mention of creation on each day. In the first account of creation, it is written, "Let there be," and it was be like there was evening and morning. But in the second account of creation, the story is prose, and God said, and it was evening. In the first account of creation, it is orderly, but in the second account of creation, no order was there. In the first account of creation, it mentioned what was created on which day. In the second account of creation, it does not mention what was created on which day. Another difference is that in the first account of creation, rivers and gardens are mentioned, while in the second account of creation, there is no mention of rivers and gardens for Tyrene. In the first account of creation, rivers and gardens are not mentioned, but in the second account, mention rivers and gardens for Tyrene. In the first account of creation, man and woman were created together. Then there be man, then there be human beings. But in the second account of creation, woman was created from man's rib. So man was created first, then woman was created out of man's rib. Another difference, the first account of creation, no mention of tree of knowledge, that tree which was in the middle. There's no mention of tree of knowledge. But in the second account of creation, there's mention of the tree of knowledge in the middle, which the man, was told not to eat. In the first account of creation, marriage is for procreation. While in the second account of creation, marriage is for companionship. In the first account of creation, sun, moon, stars, skies are mentioned. But in the second account of creation, sun, moon, stars and the sky are not mentioned. In the first account of creation, God rested on the seventh day. That is the Sabbath day. But in the second account of creation, mentioning of the resting after work, but Sabbath day is not mentioned. There's no mention of Sabbath day, although God rested after work. So those are some of the differences between the first and the second account, the two accounts of creation. Then there are also similarities between the two accounts of creation. In both accounts of creation, men and women are created by God, and they are given special references. In both, men and women are created by God. In the first, remember, man was created together with woman. In the second, woman was created out of man's rib. So they are both created by God. In both accounts, God rested after creation. We are seeing God resting on the Sabbath day in the first account, and in the second, God also rested after work. In both accounts, God provided the source of food. God is the source of food in both accounts of creation. In both, God is portrayed as the sole creator of the universe and everything in it. God is portrayed as the sole creator of the universe and everything in it. In both accounts, man is given this responsibility of controlling animals. birds and plants that God created. In both accounts, man is given the responsibility of controlling animals, birds and plants that God created. So that's some, so those are some of the similarities in both accounts of creation, the two accounts of creation, that's the first account and the second account of creation. So we have looked at the differences between the first and second account of creation, and we have looked at the similarities between the two creation stories. So that's the end of our lesson, and I'll leave you with the following questions. Write down five differences between the first and the second creation stories. The second is state the similarities between the creation stories. You state the similarities between the creation stories. Then on to our references, you can refer to Secondary Christian Religious Education Student Book 1, KLB 3rd edition. Thank you for joining us. For this and more, contact us on our SMS number, which is on the screen. You can also find us on YouTube, Elimu TV, Facebook, Elimu TV, and on Twitter at Elimu_TV_KE. Until next time, bye-bye.